Hello dear friends, myself is Roshni Parikh and today's topic of discussion is a class E commutations of an SAI which is also a belongs from the force commutation. Now in a force commutation, as we see that SCR is a force to turn off by using the external commutation circuit. Now in a class E commutation, what will happen? Class E commutation is also known as the also referred as the external pulse commutation. External pulse commutation means in this commutation we are using a pulse generated by the external source to turn off the main or a working thyristor. Now let's see the diagram of a class E commutation. Now in a class E commutation, here a main thyristor or a working thyristor which is required to be turned off. Here a load is connected. Same way, here another thyristor which are connected in the inverse, that is the T2. Here a main thyristor T1, and then here a capacitor is connected. Then again a inductor is there, and the thyristor T3 is there. And here we are applying the V1, that is the external voltage. Here inductor L, capacitor C, and this circuit is energized with the VDC, or you can see a VS source voltage. So this is the diagram for a class E commutation. Now in a class E commutation, see here a commutation circuit contains, this is all the class E commutation circuit. Here it is forms the commutation circuit. That is the commutation circuit. T1, that is the main thyristor which is required to be turned off, and to turn off the main thyristor or a working thyristor we are using this external circuit, in which external circuit consisting the thyristor T2, thyristor T3, same way inductor L and the capacitor C. And here this commutation circuit is energized by the pulse which is from the external voltage source. So here we are using the pulse which is generated from the external source to turn off the main thyristor. So name is a given, so it is referred as the external pulse commutation. Now let's see the working of a class E commutation in a step by step. In a first of all, what will happen? So first of all, here a T3 is a turn on. Suppose if I say that T1 is a turn on in a stage number 1. In a stage number 1, T1 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse. Main thyristor is a turn on by applying a gate pulse or by triggering. So what will happen? Now load current is a flowing. I0 is a flowing from source to load through your thyristor T1, means a load current is flowing in this direction. In this loop load current is flowing. So your current is, when a T1 is a turn on, at that time T1 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse, at that time what will happen? Your load current starts to flow from source to load through the T1. Now if you want to turn off the thyristor T1, at that time what will happen? Then here T3 is a turn on. T3 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse, and here we are using the external source which generates the pulses. Or you can say V1, or you can say a external source, so VES. So external source is there which generate the pulses, and that pulses are given here and T3 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse. So at that time what will happen? Now current will flow from T3 through inductor, through capacitor, through the negative. And now capacitor is going to be charged with the upper plate is a positive and lower plate is a negative when the T3 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse, and this circuit is energized with the external source. So your capacitor is a charge with upper plate is a positive and lower plate is a negative. If I say the voltage across the here, that is the V1, or you can say VES. So V1, that is the voltage across the this terminal. So now capacitor is going to be charged. VC is equal to initially in a stage number 2 when T3 is a turn on. T1 is already on and T3 is a on by external voltage source. External voltage source is given to this circuit and T3 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse. At that time capacitor is a charge with upper plate is a positive and lower plate is a positive. Now what will be the capacitor charging voltage? VC is equal to not a V1, but it is a double 2V1. Why it is a 2V1? Because as we know that okay, inductor is connected here. Now initially inductor stored the energy. Inductor is stored the energy, and that stored energy, and when the capacitor is a fully charged to applied voltage, that is the V1, when capacitor voltage is equal to V1, when your capacitor voltage is equal to plus V1, then after what will happen, your inductor release the energy, and due to the stored energy of the inductor, still further charging of the capacitor is a happen, means a further charging of a capacitor is a going to be in a process. And now capacitor is a going to be charged as the 2V1, means V1 plus V1 and another V1, that is the stored energy of the inductor. As the inductor is here, that inductor supplies the current, and capacitor is going to be a further charge. So capacitor voltage, that is equal to 2V1 instead of V1. So now capacitor voltage is equal to plus 2V1. With the upper plate is a positive and lower plate is a negative. Now then after what will happen, thyristor T2 is a turn on. If you want to turn off the main thyristor, then you have to turn on the thyristor T2 by applying a gate pulse. So in a stage number 3, T2 is a turn on and already T3 is a on. And see here, once the capacitor is a fully charged to 2V1, then what will happen? What will happen? Your T3 is a turn off as the anode current is goes to 0. So now T2 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse. At that time, what will happen? When a T2 is a turn on by applying a gate pulse, at that time, that positive will get by the anode of the thyristor T2 and negative will get by the your cathode of the thyristor T2. Means what? Okay, this voltage is directly, it is a short circuited, directly short circuited. So what will happen? Capacitor voltage, which is the 2V1, is directly appear across the load. So now load voltage, if I say V0, that is the load voltage, that is equal to plus 2V1. Now your capacitor voltage is directly appear across the load. Now what will happen? See here, input voltage VDC, VS, here input voltage VS, and here a double of the your means your VS, and here a 2V1 means your load voltage is greater than the VS. So what will happen? Okay, here a 2V1, here a positive and here a negative. Input voltage, that is the VS, that is the source voltage, and that is the polarity of here a plus and here a minus, and here a load voltage which having a 2V1 with the here a positive and here a negative. But in a stage number 4, what will happen? In a stage number 4, what will happen? So here, here we your output voltage means the voltage across the load, that is the 2V1, as the T2 is a short circuited and capacitor voltage is directly appear across the load. Now load voltage, that is the 2V1, means the plus 2V1. Now in a stage number 4, now input voltage, that is the Vs only, and your load voltage, that is equal to 2V1. And as the 2V1 is greater than the Vs, input supply voltage, so what will happen? Positive will get by the your cathode, and the negative is directly appear as the anode, means this voltage is appear across the your main thyristor, and now that is as a reverse voltage. So now T1 is a turn off, as your load voltage, which is equal to 2V1, is greater than the Vs, means the voltage, so 2V1 minus Vs is appear across the thyristor, appear across T1 as the reverse voltage, and as the reverse voltage appear across the main thyristor, and main thyristor is a turn off. So here a main thyristor is a turn off by applying a external voltage to the commutation circuit. So name is given a external pulse commutation. Hope you understood. Thank you.